Christmas is approaching, and the 7 Valve-made diffuse maps in CSGO have just received new compatibility versions. This means we can expect new versions of them within the next day or so. I have no idea what Valve's going to do with them, but it's hopefully something to do with whatever Christmas update CSGO will be getting, be it a layer of snow, support for a new game mode, or Source 2 confirmed. Let's look back at past Christmases to see how CSGO celebrated those, shall we? 2012 was still very early days for the game. Throughout the month of December, it received numerous updates which were just there to make the game more playable, and weren't especially Jesus-y themed. But on Christmas Eve, Valve gave the game some holiday cheer in the form of Christmas hats and a decoration around the edges of the screen to show you just how much you got pwned. There might have been more to this update than just that, but back then nobody was really paying attention, so coverage was limited. 2013 is when things got exciting. CSGO received the Winter Offensive update, which shipped with 2 new maps, Overpass and Cobblestone. Both were very different from how they are today. One received lots of updates and is now loved, while the other got lots of updates and was removed from the game. Back in 2013, both were only available for people who had bought Operation Bravo. This was before the game opened operations up to everybody. From 2014 onwards, we were all given access to Operation content, but people who pay for it are rewarded with exclusive items and drops. Another feature that rolled out for Christmas 2013 were the gifts, which could be bought and given to other players or viewers in your current match, because those were simpler times. As well as all of this, there was the Winter Offensive weapon case, the esports case, and a few updates to maps like Assault and Sugarcane. In 2014, we got the new train, and although this new map was added to Operation Vanguard, which was running at the time, things had changed since last time, and the new map was now also free for everybody else to use as well. Train was the first time a map in CSGO had received a makeover, and there was much rejoicing. The M4A1S at this time was being used about 4 times more than the M4A4 was, so in this update had its price upped to $3,100, making it the same as the M4A4. The Deagle had its price dropped from $800 to $700, and the CZ got majorly nerfed, having its ammo dropped from 12 to 8, its equip time increased, and its damage, fire rate, and kill bonus all reduced. And the Tech-9 got a secret buff to its damage at range and accuracy. In 2015, we got a new weapon, the revolver. What followed were several happy days of one-hit kill shots to the chest and groin, because Valve hadn't thought through the weapon very well at all. Its running accuracy, combined with high damage, made it a formidable weapon, in many instances being a better choice than rifles that were 4 times its price were. It was completely broken, but was quickly fixed in subsequent updates over the following 2 days. We also got the revolver case, and several community-made sticker capsules. Chickens got beautiful red knitted sweaters. The AK and M4 both got nerfs to discourage spraying and tap shooting. And the round time and C4 timer both received 5-second reductions to try and speed stuff up a bit. But to counter this, the timeout feature was introduced, which I'm sure we're all familiar with these days. This was also when the death cam was introduced, replaying your death from the enemy's point of view, to show you how much you got pwned. In 2016, we got HRTF audio. People still complain that it's hard to know which direction a sound's coming from, but before this update, it was even worse. I suspect all of these changes were made to help with the vertical nature of the map, Nuke, because on that map, players were always getting confused about which site the bomb had been planted at. And that map got a few changes too. You could no longer plant on the tops of the silos on either site, and the railings above the sites were reshuffled around. And we got this room in B that was later removed again. Also, the SAS model received a makeover. The improvement didn't come in the form of more polygons, but rather a more cartoonish style, higher resolution textures, and lots of external details that would flop around as he moved about. And the chickens received sweaters again, only this year they were green instead of the red designs from 2015. There wasn't so much new content in 2017. Operation Hydra had just ended, and in December the game was gearing up for the Boston Major the following year. The player stickers and graffiti for this were rolled out in the lead up to Christmas though. The holiday cheer this year was deployed on the 19th of December. The biggest change was to how the shotguns worked. Before this point, their spray was random, but after this followed a set pattern, so if you practiced a certain shotgun enough, you could grow familiar with where the individual pellets would land, and use that knowledge to hit players more effectively. 2018 featured the biggest Christmas celebration ever, possibly even the biggest update CSGO has ever received, because this is when the game went free to play, and when it received the Danger Zone game mode. For years, people thought CSGO was dying because Battle Royale was the cool thing, but after this update, they had to think up some other reason to blame it on. And the game got a new weapons case as well. And then, later on in the month, the hostage map Militia received a new wintry theme, which it still has to this day. The C4 was gift-wrapped to make it look like a present, I wrongly speculated at the time that when this was torn off the following January that it would reveal the high polygon C4 model that everybody had been talking about at the time, but this didn't happen. And snowballs were rolled out. These were a cool new weapon that Valve just casually threw in along with everything else. If you had enough balls, you could try using them instead of weapons. A direct strike would blind other players, similarly to a flashbang. Makes you wonder why SWAT doesn't use these things instead. And lastly, 2019's Christmas period came just after a series of exciting new announcements. Operation Shattered Web was underway, being the first operation the game had received in over 2 years. December had several related updates, like improved bot AI for the upcoming co-op missions, and several model updates to improve visibility, which had been a concern ever since the custom models rolled out as part of the new operation. It was around this time that Half-Life Alyx had just been announced too. I think everybody was excited for that at the time, and I was happy messing about with my Valve Index VR set. In terms of game updates, it received similar Christmas cheer to 2018's in the form of falling snow on the menu, throwable snowballs, a wrapped C4, and festive chickens. That's kind of expected every year now, so if it doesn't happen sometime this December, then I'll be very disappointed. Luckily, there is still time. I tracked the date the holiday cheer had been rolled out each year. The earliest was in 2016, and that was still December the 7th. The latest was in 2012, on Christmas Eve. But I think we can forget about that since it was super early in Counter-Strike's life. It tends to roll out anywhere between the 7th of December and a week before Christmas. So if it was rolled out tonight, then that would be unusually early. But beyond the superficial festive theme, what else can we expect? We expect something. It's not like they've recently given us a new operation or anything like that. There hasn't been anything for months. The game has never been this quiet before. Earlier in the year, Valve were still hard at work finishing up Half-Life Alyx. Then with coronavirus, everything went weird, but Left 4 Dead 2 still saw a large update a few months back. Let's hope Christmas is CSGO's time to shine, starting tonight. Valve, please.